Good morning, dear students. Today we have with us one of my students, Miss Amrita R.A. from second year CZBT from KLE Society's S. Nizhalingappa College, Bengaluru. Today she'll be presenting her seminar talk on chemical bonding. Now, this virtual platform is yours. Now, over to Miss Amrita.
Thank you, ma'am. I am Amrita R.A. from 2nd CZBT. I am here today to present a topic on chemical bonding. First of all, before beginning my presentation, I would like to thank Pratibha ma'am for giving me this opportunity. Thank you, ma'am. Now I'll start with my presentation, chemical bonding. Chemical bonding. A chemical bond is the force that holds atom together. That means there is a force which holds two different atoms together. The bond formation between the atoms is mainly the result of redistribution, grouping, and reorientation of electrons. That means only electrons involved in chemical bonding. The whole chemical bonding phenomenon is because to attain stability. There are mainly three types of chemical bonds, that is ionic bond and covalent bond and coordinate bond. Now, starting on with ionic bond. Ionic bond is an electrostatic force of attraction established when electron from the outermost shell of one atom is transferred to the outermost shell of the other atom. That means in the outer electronic configuration of an atom, there'll be the valence electrons. Transfer of those electrons leads to the ionic bond. For example, sodium chloride. During the formation of sodium chloride, sodium atom loses one electron to attain non-electronic configuration. And on the other hand, chlorine atom gains one electron and attains argon's electronic configuration. This is how the ionic bond is formed between Na and Cl. Coming on to the properties of ionic bond. Ionic bond are rigid solids. Since there is a strong electrostatic force of attraction between ions, the ions cannot be easily separated. They have high melting and boiling point. They are soluble in water but insoluble in organic solvents. They are good conductors of electricity as they have free electrons. Next, moving on to covalent bond. Covalent bond is a chemical bond formed by the mutual sharing of electrons between two reacting atoms, both of which attain stable electronic configuration. There is no transfer of electron involved in covalent bond. The number of covalent bond formed, that is single, double, and triple bond, mainly depends on the number of shared pair of electrons. Here, looking at the examples, we can see that there is a single bond formed between O and H of the water molecules. And here there will be only one electron pair shared between the molecules. And now coming on to the double bond, there is two pair of electrons shared between C and O. And in the triple bond, there is three pair of electrons, that is six electrons, are shared between two different atoms of nitrogen. Next, properties of covalent bond. Covalent bonds have definite geometrical shape, bond length, bond angle, and bond energy. They are generally gases or low boiling liquids or low melting solids at ordinary temperature. They do not conduct electricity as they don't have any free electrons. They are generally soluble in non-polar organic solvents such as benzene, but insoluble in water. Next is van der Waals bonds. Bonds are formed by the force of attraction or repulsion of molecules due to unequal distribution of electrons between the bound atoms. They are the weak bonds compared to ionic and covalent. Here you can see the unequal distribution of electrons leading to partial negative charge, and here it is partial positive charge. They do form van der Waals force. And here it is a polypeptide chain of an amino acid. Here you can see the van der Waals force acting. Van der Waals bonds are important to maintain the three-dimensional structure of proteins for their proper function. Hydrogen bond. Hydrogen bond is a strong electrostatic force of attraction between the hydrogen atom, which is covalently linked to the electronegative atom. The electronegative atoms may be fluorine, oxygen, or nitrogen. There are two types of hydrogen bonding. One is intramolecular and another one is intermolecular. Intermolecular, there are two molecules involved, like it is H and F of different molecules. And here it is the one single molecule in intramolecular bonding. Here is the hydrogen bond. Importance of hydrogen bond. Hydrogen bond is responsible for water's unique solvent capabilities. Hydrogen bond holds complementary strands of DNA together. Hydrogen bond is responsible for determining the three-dimensional structure of folded proteins, including enzymes and antibodies. Next is peptide bond. A peptide bond is an amide type of bond which is covalently linked between two alpha amino acids. They are formed by joining of carboxyl group of one amino acid to the amino group of another amino acid. During this formation, there will be release of water molecules. Here, as you see, this is an amino acid and this is an amino acid. Here the carboxyl group of one amino acid bonding to the amino group of another. This is the dipeptide chain. You can even get tripeptide and polypeptide there, depending upon the number of amino acids. Importance of polypeptide bonds. Polypeptide bond is the basic of most of biological reactions, as they are used by the amino acids to form proteins which are supporting structures. They also catalyze the important reaction in our body or in the living system. Thank you. I first of all like to thank Pratibha ma'am again for giving me such a great opportunity to present my presentation in this platform, and I would like to thank everyone who has listened to me patiently. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Ms. Amrita, for your presentation on chemical bonding. Q&A session class we will conduct in offline class. Thank you everyone for joining us.